Hello viewers, in today's video we are going to discuss about algebra to graph properly. You know that in, especially in physics practical, we have some figures that is a little tricky. That's the reason why we are going to treat how to plot physics, how to plot graph in physics practical, because most of their figures are a little bit tricky. The first thing you need to do is you need to know which one you are plotting against which one. If it is stated that plot V against X, it means that that V, the first mentioned one is the Y axis, while the one mentioned next, the one you are plotting against is the X axis. That's the first one. The second one, you need to know how to scale the graph, how to scale your graph. Like in today's video, we are to plot. In today's, we are plotting this table. We are plotting V inverse against X inverse. If you can see this figure, they are very small or tricky figure, and we need to know how to space our graph properly. Now, if you look at this V, it ranges from 6 to 1. It ranges from 6 to 1, which means that if you use this whole number there, it's okay, it's well spaced. And this one is ranging from 0.05 to 0.1. So if you use 0.1 as the interval, it's still okay. Or you use 0.005, which is half of 0.1, it's still okay. But in today's table, we are going to use 0.1 on our X inverse axis, and we use 1.0 on our V inverse axis. So this is the table, but I just brought this one out so as to be easier for us to plot. How many minutes now? So this is the graph in which we are using to plot our table, and as you can see, now we have spaced them out. We have this place to be 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, 4.0, 5.0, and so on and so forth. This place, we have this place to be 0.01, 0.02, 0.03, 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, and so on and so forth for the X inverse and for the V inverse axis. Now, from the table here, we have our first data to be on X inverse axis. We have 0.05, which is this 0.050, which is this one. Y on our V inverse axis, we have to be 6.66. We have our if this place, from this place to this place, is 1, which means that each box here is 0.1, because we have 10 of it there. Then divided by 1 will give us 0.1. Let's see, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 7, 8, 9, and 1.0, like that. If this space is 0.01, therefore in each box you have 0.001 there. Like if this place is 0.001, 002, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0.01 to complete this first box. And don't forget, each box is 2 centimeters, that is the 10 of it is 2 centimeters on each box. This way, which means that on the V inverse axis, we are representing it, this one as 1 unit represents 2 centimeters on V inverse axis. Then you can put that one somewhere, right? One, or you say 2 centimeters rep 1 unit on V inverse axis. Y on X inverse axis, we have 0.01 represents 2 centimeters. Therefore, you write 2 centimeters rep 0.01 unit on X inverse axis. That's that. You put this one too under this one, which is 2 centimeters rep 1 unit on X inverse axis, X inverse axis, So that is the scale. Then the next thing you still need to do is the title of the graph. Since you are putting V inverse against X inverse, you write title, and write V graph of, right? Graph of V inverse against X inverse. Graph of V inverse against X inverse. Now you can start your plotting. On our data, the first one is 0.05, on the x inverse axis, y 6.6 on the y inverse axis. Remember that this one is 6, right? This is 6.1, 6.2, 6.3, 6.4, 6.5, 6.6. Since the 6.6 is, therefore, it can be between 6.7 and 6.6. Then we now trace this one to 0.05. This is 0.05, and this is 6.6. E 6.6, E 6.66, very close to 6.7 on that first one. Now, on the second data, we have 0.033. Therefore, this is 0.02, 0.03. Therefore, 0.033 means that since each ball is 0.01, therefore, we have three boxes like that. 0.031, 0.032, 0.033 is somewhere here. Therefore, we are putting it against 5.0. This is our 5.00. Then we trace it out. We have it to be here. We have it to be here. You can use your ruler so as not to get confused. We have this 5.0. Then map that one out. Then the next data here we are having is 0.025 against 3.333. This is 0.02. Then 0.025 should be between 0.02 and 0.03. Let's count 0.021, 0.22, 0.23, 0.24, 0.25. Then we have it to be here against 3.3. This is 3.0, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3. Therefore, you now mark it out to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 against 3.3. 1, 2, 3, which is here. Then the next data is 0.020, 0.020. This is the place against 2.5, against 2.5. This is 2.0, 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then against 0.020. Therefore, we trace this one out. We have it to be like this. That's 0.02. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then the next one is 0.016. This is 0.01. Then we count 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 0.016 against what? 2.0. Against 2.0. I'll trace this one out. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore, we have this one to be like this. Against 2.0. Don't forget that. We'll mark that one out. Then the next one is 0.031. 0.013, we have this place to be 0.01, 011, 012, 013 against 1.6. If this place is 1, then you count 6, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore, it is somewhere here. Then mark this place out, and that is our point on the graph. Now, how do you locate the line? Line is just distance between two points. And even if it is just 2 points, if you want to locate, it's okay. And if you want to locate more than that, it's still okay. But what if your point is scattered? If your point is scattered, just locate in between the scattered one. Just if one is here and one is here, then use the between. Understand? And if it is not scattered like this one, now we have at least 1, 2, 3, 4, which is arranged on one another. We have 1, 2, 3, 2, which is close. We have 1, 2. Don't use this one. No, it's wrong. It's wrong. Because we have series of data here. Then don't use this one. We need to use the one that we have. Okay. Therefore, we can use this one. This one is a better thing because it's much more compared to that one. Then what we do is we join it, join them together. A very good it reach? Is either the x-axis, y-axis, or the origin? So, and that is the graph. Okay, now, since we are done with the graph and we have chosen a reasonable point to use as our line, to calculate the slope now. Slope is known as change in y over change in x. Okay, now if that is the case, from here on our y is v inverse, change in v inverse over our x is what? Change in x inverse. I choose this one, you can choose any convenient point in which you want to use, but for me I choose 7 and 1. From the 7, you trace it down to where it crossed that line, I trace it down to x inverse axis. The same thing from y, trace it down to the line, I trace it down to the x inverse axis. From here down to this place, to the x inverse is this around, since this place is 0.05, the 0.051 is 0.052, and that is our big x, the maximum x. While this place is 0.01234567 89, it is 0.009. Now you remove this one from this one, it will be around 0.343. You remove this one, so that is 7 minus this one, will give you 6. Then 6 divided by 0.043, it will give you 139. That is 139.535. Supposed to be 139.5348, but I have approximated it to 3 decimal places since our table is in 3 decimal places. And that is the all concerning our graph and calculate this slope. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel, my Wamba Shiro, and for more videos, click the notification button. Thanks.